for you. You don't see the battle going on. But there is a battle that's happening right now over you. But one thing we can be grateful to God for is that we are signed, sealed, and delivered by the glory of Jesus Christ. So come, take your best shot. See, he tried to kill you in 2016. But let me tell you, you ought to tell the devil you should have killed me while you had a chance. Because you allowed me to come in this place tonight. See, listen, if the only one that's going to be upset is the devil. Amen? The only one that's mad is the enemy. Because the people of God are gathered together in one place. And I know I have some believers in the house tonight. Amen? Paradise, God bless you. We want to take this opportunity to welcome those who are visiting with us tonight. And we pray that you feel the Spirit, that you know that you're known in the generous grace that God is here. The presence of the Lord is with us. And truly, we are grateful for your presence tonight. Amen. Let's give our visitors a great big hand. Amen. Blessed of the Lord tonight. There's so many things that has transpired over the past 12 months, but it's one thing that has been consistent. There's one thing that has not changed, and that is the love that God has for us. You know, people change. We change houses, you change jobs, you change a lot of things, but he said, I am God, and I change it now. I'm the same yesterday, today, and forever. I called a friend of mine because God showed me some things early on during the year, the time that we're in now. And I called a friend of mine and said, man, I said, God has put something in my heart to do on New Year's Eve, to watch me. And he gave me the scripture. I'll give you the scripture later on, but I just want to share with you that when you prepare to do something for God, he will prepare the way, the supplies, the means, everything necessary for you to be successful in what you set out to do for him. Only what you do for Christ will last